Welcome back from the short break. If you are 24 and below and you are done with campus, probably graduated last week at Makerere University, and you're looking for a job, you're looking for an opportunity, you're looking to place yourself in something that will make your life better, this is a chance for you to probably sit back, relax, increase the volume on your TV, and listen to what we're about to conversate about. In studio, I have a project manager from Employment and Skills for Eastern Africa, and that is Donald Agaba. He's here to talk about gas and oil, the opportunities that are there. How do you place yourself in some of these places so that you can, you know, improve on your life? Donald, welcome on the show.
Thanks, Alwyn.
How do you, you know, feel coming out of oil, the business of oil, and onto television?
I feel good.
Yeah.
Now, before you get into the organization or the project that you have, there's a notion that oil is meant for a selected few. Some people do not get information with regards to opportunities in oil. Mm-hmm. Is that true?
No, that's definitely not true. Yeah. First of all, I think there's a general misunderstanding of the oil and gas sector, the oil sector in this case. There are a lot of opportunities that come out of investments in the sector, but people just don't have necessary information. The government is doing a lot to disseminate information. There's a lot of fora for information exchange and stuff like that. The Petroleum Authority and the Ministry of Energy always have events, and they go around the country trying to sensitize people, but mainly it's just a lack of information, you know. So there's lots of tiers where people can fit in and benefit, and the construction sector is one of them.
And the good thing is that he actually asked that, because I had a friend of mine who, the moment it became real talk that there were, yes, there was oil, we're going to do all of this, and they started the whole process, she did a course. Yeah. Because in Dubai, it's easier to do the courses there because they do them a lot. But when she came back here, she's like, okay, so wait, do I sit and wait for a job? Do I ask for a job? Are they even hiring? You know, so those are, like you said, a lack of information. Yeah. And now you come out and you tell us from the ages of 18 to 24, you're here to give them all this information to let them know you can be a part of this. You just have to do this and this and this and this. I think it's a good thing because that's job creation in a way.
Yeah.
In more ways than the other.
Yeah.
Okay. So now it begs the question, what is the project about?
So the project, it's basically a training, a skilling project. You were talking about your friend going to Dubai to take this training and stuff like that. The majority of jobs in the sector, there's different phases. So there's like a construction phase.
Yeah.
And so the majority of employment comes out during that phase.
Okay.
But a lot of jobs are not really at a high level. They're like mid and very low level jobs, which is where this information plays a big factor, with people studying the wrong stuff. And they're not just being as much demand for skills that they have and stuff like that, and they're being a mismatch.
Okay, if we're talking about skills, because you've said, yes, these jobs don't need to be high-level jobs and all of that. We're starting with the simple jobs. What are some of the jobs that an 18-year-old could do? Is it at an oil rig? Is it in an office? Where will the jobs be?
Well, what we're focusing on, and what this project specifically is focusing on, is actually entry-level construction jobs. And the construction sector is just one sector that feeds into the oil and gas industry, right?
Okay.
So there's actual building. So there's people like heavy equipment operators, there's people like pipe fitters, there's people like just, you know, regular construction workers, all those electricians and stuff like that, lower level.
Yeah.
Technicians.
Yeah.
There's welding, all these different things, which is not so low level. But there's different tiers, right? And then that feeds into engineering and project management and all that. But a lot of these skills are transferable, so it's not just for the oil sector.
True.
If you're a construction worker, if you're a builder, you can work on an oil refinery, building that, but you can also do road construction depending on what you do.
True.
So what? Yeah, so you were asking what the project is actually about, right?
Mm-hmm.
This project has a very, I would say, narrow focus, because it's only training people for entry-level positions in the construction sector, right? And it's not necessarily only for oil and gas, because we are trying to do skills that are as transferable as possible. So like I said, you can transfer your skills from one industry to another.
Into another,
right?
With smooth transition.
Why do you then have an age gap to it?
We have an age gap to it because, first of all, you know about, you know, the youth bulge in Uganda.
Yeah.
That's the largest demographic.
1.8 million unemployed.
Exactly. And also because in the areas that we're focusing on, Pakwach and again, Kampala, it's a huge demographic, and it's entry-level work. So this is not necessarily skills for somebody that's been working for years and years, and then they want to retrain and, you know. It's quite entry-level. However, we've noticed that there's a huge demand for, there's been a huge demand for this project for people that are above 24 years old. So that's also subject to review. So just encourage everybody.
Because 30-year-olds in this country are stronger than a 20-year-old. They are hungry.
Let's first get us serious a bit here. Is it true that there is money in oil?
Oh, come on.
No, listen.
Really? Liquid gold.
Since government said that oil is coming through. And all those 3 years.
Do you know how many? Do you know how many? How many? Because I was reading, and they were saying in ground, what they assume we could have is about 2.5
No, forget them.
So that you have like a full.
These guys are training 18 to 20-year-old people. Yeah. And of course, there's this idea that, you know what, oil is the next big thing. There's money. Blah, blah, blah. Now I want to ask you, who is in oil? Mm-hmm. Is it true that there's money in oil? If you say yes, I'm switching career.
And, you won't leave me until you're alone.
But I mean, so there is, but it just, you have to be qualified, you know? You have to have the right skills for the right job.
Yeah.
And if you have those, once opportunities do come online, then yeah. You can earn a good living, and that's what this project is about. It's about skilling people for entry level construction skills, so that they can have a stepping stone
to get into the
industry and other employment, right? Because right now there's a huge mismatch. People go to school for a lot of, you know, fancy things, but a lot of times what's being demanded by industry and what's forecast to be demanded by industry.
No one can actually deliver because that's what I actually noticed when they send me the write-up. I'm like, okay, this is a good idea. Did you remember those days when the vocational institutes pretty much gave us everything we have around us?
Mm-hmm.
It was vocational, and then it reached a point where the deal now was not to go vocational and learn a skill or anything. They sold the fallacy to us that for you to be something in society, you have to go get an education, get a huge degree. You don't even know what you're going to do. You get, but I think
just do it.
But I think this is a good initiative for all the youth out there. Yes, yesterday we were calling you out and telling you stop waiting for government to give you bags of money. That money is not going to take you anywhere if you have a skill or if you're prepared to learn a skill. This is the best time. 18 to 24, you can actually move to Pakwach. There is no problem. What are you doing in Kampala?
This brings me to a question, though. Why are you focusing on, you know, Pakwach?
So we're focusing on Kampala and Pakwach because, first of all, Pakwach is one of the regions that's going to see a lot of investment in that sector. But we feel like not a lot of activities in terms of capacity building of the local population have gone on there. There's lots of activities in Hoima and neighboring districts, but not necessarily Pakwach. Yet there are going to be labor demands over there. And we do everything that we do in consultation and working very closely with the government, particularly the Ministry of Energy and the Ministry of Education. And so we made all these plans with them. We were advised by them to focus there. Yeah, and so that's one of the main reasons that we're working over there.
What if I stay in Karamoja, Soroti, but I would move and stay in Pakwach? Yeah. Am I eligible to
Yes, you're 100% eligible if you meet all the other eligibility requirements. So if you're between 18 and 24 years old, if you can afford your accommodation for the duration of your training. If you can read, write, have basic numeracy skills and stuff like that, you can definitely qualify, and we encourage everybody to apply.
What's the longevity of this?
So this is really short entry-level training, which can be built on, right? So it's internationally certified by the Engineering Construction Industry Training Board, which is ECITB, which is one of the benefits that you get actually from attending the training.
Yeah.
And level one in entry-level construction with a big focus on health and safety and also a focus on life skills, not only the technical construction skills, but attitudes, ethics, work ethics, and all that stuff.
Okay.
That initially is 6 weeks, and then after that, there'll be, for people that perform well, there'll be a level two training, which is more specialized in either rigging or pipe fitting.
Do they have to pay a fee? You know,
it's 100% free, with lunch provided. And there's going to be 8 cohorts. So starting next month, it's going to go on 8 times.
Okay.
So for about a year. So it's, I mean, it's, I think it's a really, it's a worthwhile program. And another one of the really big benefits of the program is, like, we try to link you into employment. There are no guarantees for jobs.
But you'll try.
No guarantees for jobs, but that's a really strong component of the project.
Because we're not just... get probably a recommendation after.
Of course.
Yeah, not only a recommendation, but there's active efforts to try to link with industry. Industry is on board with this project. They help us to develop the project. Not only the oil and gas industry, but the overall construction industry. So we were in consultation with a lot of construction companies during the development of it, and we're trying to work out industrial attachments, placements.
So there are chances you could actually come for the training, get these skills, and end up getting a job if you're good at what you would do.
There are chances.
There are high chances.
Yes.
You're talking about it being free if you can take care of your accommodation and, you know, living expenses. Who is funding that project? Who are you?
That's a very good question. So the project is being implemented by GIZ, which is a German development corporation, but it's funded by the British government, so UK aid, DFID, as well as the Norwegian government, the German government, and Royal Dutch Shell, which is Shell.
Whoa, those are too many. Yeah. Too many big...
Yeah, it's a big name. But it's also working in very, very close partnership with the government. We actually sit at the Ministry of Energy. So those are our partners, our direct partners, and the Ministry of Education. And it's being implemented by GIZ in collaboration with a consortium of a consulting company called Gopa and Solid Rock.
In a nutshell, people, it's legitimate. It is not fake.
No, it's
legit. Real. It's
legit. So how do I, because someone now is interested, how do they...
The process.
Get yep. to you, to the project, how do they start? How do they apply for the...
So it's very easy. You either go to UCC Pakwach, Pacher Community Polytechnic, or Nakawa Vocational Training Institute here. But actually, you should go to MTech, which is where the actual registration is taking place. But then the project will be running at MTech and Nakawa. But to register, just go to MTech, UCC Pacher, and Pakwach Community Polytechnic. Okay. Or you can go onto social media. The Twitter handle is at SkillUpUG, and on Facebook, it's Skills for Construction. And you can also call toll-free 0200-522-452. Or 0702-096-326, and you'll get run through the registration process.
Now, okay, as we're already done with the conversation here, let's just broaden it for a minute. Just give me some of those other professions that have opportunities in the oil sector. Most of us think that when you talk about the oil sector, it's engineers, plumbers.
And that's just pretty much like down, you know, there's like a gap.
What are some of those? Do you guys need like...
they don't want a talkative person.
HR people, or I don't know.
I mean, there's all those...
messengers.
That's your job right there. It's a startup.
What are some of those opportunities? Young graduate, a guy who's just finished his guidance and counseling degree at Macquarie.
Yeah.
What are some of the opportunities?
Well, most... professions are required. A lot of professions are required, definitely human resource people and stuff like that. But it's not only direct employment in the oil and gas sector. Remember, this is a sector that's supported
by lots of different sectors,
right? So think about hospitality and accommodation in an area like Hoima. There's going to be lots of workers, and there's going to be huge needs for logistical support, for accommodation, for cleaning services, all those things. So when you start thinking about that, and not just direct employment, but indirect and induced employment, you can see why there's all this hype.
Even Mama Nachi, who is doing, probably Katogo can do a restaurant. Yes.
We're all going to my homeland. I mean, big up to everyone. I'm from there, man. Like, we're in there.
Oh my God. Thank you very much for your time.
Cool.
Thank you for taking a minute off and coming to explain some of these things to us. We'd like to join the oil sector, but we don't know how.
How to.
And thanks to you now, I can probably think about buying some piece of land in Pakwach. But that's all we've had for you today on Urban Today. We hope that you enjoyed the show and you picked a thing or two about it. Please don't forget to take a minute off and celebrate the life of Oliver Mutu, because he's been such a great legend in Africa. And of course, one of your shout outs was one of those. If you're a comedian,
holla
at Tina.
Holla at me. And of course, for all of you who didn't get the information that he was giving out for the toll-free numbers and the Twitter handles, it's quite simple. Go to our different Twitter handles. That's on Urban TV. Urban TV on Twitter, or you can hit me up at CineFS1, hit up Willis Daily, and we'll give you all that information. Let's try and employ one more youth who is not going to go and ask for the government or to the situation. It's been a good thing working up with you.
If you've won a ticket to Spice Diana, tweet us or come collect it at Urban TV. Mm. You won a ticket for the Kampala Color Fun Run, come and collect it for us. We'll be in Jinja kayaking as showing your movie, The 27 Guns, tomorrow at 2 p.m. and the Motocross Championships on Sunday. We'll see you again tomorrow for Turn Up Friday with DJ Sheila. Enjoy the rest of your day.